my calculations.
Yes. But what will the future look like? Will it look like this? Don't get your hopes up. Tonight, we present a view of the future as it really will be. Some call it science fiction. We call it science fact. You'll call it The Adventures of Mike, Ron, and Antar.
Pretty low on fuel, so maybe we can stop in there, fill up, get something to eat.
Good idea. Near as I can figure, we got about 55 light years to go if we stay on Intergalactic 66.
Well, let's just hope we don't run into any more asteroids.
Hey, Mike.
Yeah.
You ever get tired of just kicking around the universe?
Oh, sure. You know, maybe the next galaxy will get a good job and settle down.
Oh, there's a time warp junction up ahead. We better pull over.
Don't worry, I'm gearing down to some light speed right now.
He's a mutant, poor fellow.
Yeah, probably caught in that 1962 atomic war.
Boy, that's some souped-up engine you got there. What do you got under the hood?
Oh, just some special modifications.
It's a nasty dent. You guys run into some trouble?
Yeah.
Asteroids. A whole bunch of them.
You guys are lucky to be alive.
Say, listen, you know a place around here where a fella can get something to eat?
Well, Xenon's is right over there. You get a pretty good space burger and a shake there.
Mmm, space burger, shake. Xenon's.
When I give someone a ride halfway across the galaxy, I expect them to come across.
Get your paws off me, you plutonian creep!
Come on, baby, how about a smooch?
Hey,
why don't you pick on some of your own size?
Says who?
Says me.
Boy, what a...
Well, I don't think you'll have to worry about that mutant anymore. Well, you want me to wait in the rocket ship or what?
Where are you going?
Opposite.
Oh, that's right along the way. We can give you a lift.
Along the way? We're going to the Crab Nebula. That's 1,000 light years out of the way.
Well, then maybe we'd better get moving.
Look, that's all the money I got, I tell you.
You're lying. Come on, give me that money.
Why don't you pick out some of your own size? Nice kick, Antar.
Nice punch, Mike Ron.
Nice heads on both of you.
Boy, I hope you don't judge us all by the likes of him. It's guys like that who give us mutants a bad name.
No sweat. Say, it's 5280.4. We better get going to the Crab Nebula before the time warp's closed. Come on.
Beach ball.
Whereabouts in Alpha Centauri do you live?
Where did you boys say you were going?
Crab Nebula.
That's good enough for me.
One of these men is Micron Zegrabar, man of the future. Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Micron Zegrabar, man of the future.
Number two.
My name is Micron Zegrabar, man of the future.
Number three.
My name is Micron Zegrabar, man of the future.
Tell the truth, tomorrow night at 8:30 on SCTV.
The Onion Field, a true story. John Savage is Officer Carl Hettinger. Ted Danson is Officer Ian Campbell. Ronnie Cox is Inspector Brooks. James Woods, the actor, portrays Greg Powell, the criminal. Franklin Seals, the actor, portrays Jimmy Smith, the criminal. The Onion Field, from Avco Embassy Pictures, rated R.
Starts Friday, September 28th at a selected theater near you.
Then you should see more. Dinty more. So, when it comes to chunkiness, well, what more can I say? Dinty more.
Hair blowers, curling irons, hot rollers. They can give you heat-dried hair, and heat-dried hair needs more than a regular shampoo. You need the clean that can take it. Flex Balsam and Protein Shampoo. Revlon's unique shampoo clears dirt and grease, but Flex is so rich in conditioning and moisturizing, even heat-dried hair comes bouncy, full of body clean. The more you do to your hair, the more you need Flex Balsam and Protein Shampoo. Flex Conditioner, too, from Revlon.
At Berman's, we have more leathers than you can imagine. More sleek leather jackets than you'll find at Studio 54. More Shirlings than at Jackson Hole, Wyoming. More dress coats than you'll find at an opening night. More top quality leather jackets and coats than you can imagine. At prices you never dreamed of. Berman's, the leather experts.
Next Thursday night on SCTV, one ship, one ocean, one tyrant in command, and a crew whose shattered spirit leads them to mutiny.
King George wants bread plants in 3 months. By God, he'll get bread plants in 3 months if I have to break the back of every man on this ship. You! Get away from that water! The water's for plants only.
For God's sake, Captain, I'm so thirsty I can hardly spit.
That's why it's the pest.
We don't even have silence. Mr. Christie! Come on. Mr. Christie!
It's Swishbuckler.
Watch your tongue, Mr. Christie, or it'll be the last for you.
The last.
Silence! No one drinks water aboard this ship except me. I can drink as much water as I want.
Well, what if the men don't drink? What if they just want to rinse a few things out?
No water.
Not even a drop behind the ear?
No water, Mr. Christie.
You're in big trouble. Sassy little sailor, aren't you? Captain, you're no longer in command of this ship. I'm relieving you.
You'll pay for this, Mr. Christie.
Quiet, just a second. Look, anybody that wants water, there it is.
Oh, great, let's have water.
I've got an idea. Let's tie him up.
Get your hands off me.
No parties.
No parties aboard this ship until we redecorate it. It's just a bit too butch for me. Tell you what. We'll all go to the islands. The season's just starting.
Swishbuckler, a fairy tale adventure on the high seas. Swishbuckler. Watch out for it on SCTV.
Throughout recorded history, great men of genius and insight have shared one mystical truth that unified man's total spiritual awareness. What is that truth? It's the universal miracle of pyramid power. The ancient lines of the pyramid focus and concentrate those powerful rays into a miraculous healing and preserving force that can mummify dead animal tissue as it mummified the pharaohs of old. So stop wasting valuable time and money on dead-end spiritual pursuits. Listen to these testimonials on pyramid power.
My cold sore went away.
I thought my mother would call, and she did.
I dreamed about fish and had fish for dinner.
So send today, Pyramid Power, Great Pyramid, Giza, Egypt. Now available in groovy denim.
How ridiculous.
Yeah. Hey,
starting to rain. Oh, let's get out of here. Yeah. Forgot your hat, didn't you?
Yeah. Well, I tell you, I'm gonna get drenched. Let me put the top up.
And now, beside the point, America's longest-running forum of public affairs.
Good day. I'm your host, Marvin O'Shea, and welcome to Beside the Point. I was a little late getting here this morning because I had some car trouble. I think it might be some moisture in the gas line because the car started, then it stalled, then it started again, then it stalled, so I had to get out of the car, and I opened up the hood. But that's beside the point. Our guest today is General Hag Hamatzos, leader of Israel's right-wing Tsurist Party. And questioning General Hamatzos today will be Ralph Stegman of the Buffalo Times-Picayune, Bill Caldwell of the Los Angeles Times, and Farley Picayune of the Miami Times Buffalo. Let's start the questioning with Farley Picayune.
General, there have been a number of major changes in the military and the political situation, but the big question in the Middle East still seems in my mind to be the Great Pyramid. Who do you think built it and why?
What? I thought we were going to discuss the political conflict on the West Bank, this pyramid.
Well, you don't have to answer the question if you don't want to, General. Let's move on to Bill Caldwell.
There are a number of significant factors contributing to the crisis, but aside from that, I notice you only have one eye. How does this affect your golf game, assuming you play golf? And if not, have you given up any sports that require the use of a second working eye?
Good question, Bill.
It's ridiculous. Now, look, I'm not here to answer questions about pyramids or personal questions about my physical shortcomings. Now, does anyone have a relevant question?
Well, let's try Ralph Stegman. Ralph?
Thank you very much, Marvin. This question came to me while I was making breakfast this morning. I have hard-boiled eggs for breakfast.
What is the question?
Right. Would Israel be prepared to make any territorial concessions if it would bring about a guaranteed peace in the Middle East?
Well, you talk about concessions, it reminds me of a very funny story. It happened at your very beautiful Kennedy Airport. I was waiting by the luggage carousel, and because I lost my luggage, as usual, which happens so often on flights like that until you cross the country, they misplace your luggage. Well, anyway, this rabbi comes up to me, disguised as a priest.
If you'd like a transcript of today's Beside the Point, send 25 cents in coin to this station. See, the reason we asked for 25 cents in coin is that some guy once sent us a 25 cent Tibetan postage stamp. We took it to the stamp dealer. He said, forget it. It's not even worth a quarter. So, anyway, that's beside the point.
Well, I said to him, I'll look for him. I'll keep an eye out. I'll keep one eye out, of course, for him. And I said, no, but when I see him, I'll tell him to come in.
And now here's world champion roller skater Dorothy Hamster for Bald and Brassy.
When I was roller skating in the Olympics, I used to spend hours on end washing, conditioning, rinsing, drying, combing, brushing, and curling my hair, trying to get that perfect look until I just wanted to tear it all out. And that's just what I did with new Bald and Brassy, the easy hair remover. Strong enough to use once a month, but it's mild enough to use every day. And it makes my head feel healthy, shiny, and bouncy.
Get Bald and Brassy for the body you can see.
You know what goes on underground in the fall? Roots grow more actively. That's why it's important to use Turf Builder fertilizer now. You see, you gotta have a good root system for a beautiful lawn. And this is the best time for Turf Builder to help roots grow denser and stronger. It even helps grow more grass plants. So you'll get a thicker lawn this fall and next spring, too. But you'd better use Turf Builder now. Fall's underground growing season only comes once a year.
Turf Builder fertilizer from Scotts.
When's the last time you really enjoyed a flight?
We're Continental, and you should see us. You should see us now.
Look,
protects, it wears, it shines. It's America's number one nail protection. Sally Hansen's patented hard as nails with nylon. Each shade contains the clear hard as nails formula for split, chipped, problem nails. So you get hard as nails protection plus beautiful color all in one. Wet plums, soft pinks, an endless choice of shiny, long-wearing color. With Sally Hansen hard as nails, protection can be beautiful.
At these leading stores.
I use a Gillette Good News Twin Blade Disposable Razor.
I use a one blade disposable.
Good News has two micro smooth blades, too. And two blades shave me closer and safer than any one blade disposable.
This has one blade. One. And one blade doesn't shave me as close and safe as his two blade Good News. I'll get Good News.
Gillette Good News shaves closer and safer than any one blade disposable. Good News, the best disposable razor you can buy.
SCTV now concludes its programming day. But first, words to live by with Dr. Bradley Omar, Universal Church of Science.
Good evening. In the face of ever-increasing threats from our enemies abroad, where can we Americans look for the strength and courage to go on? Where can we look for the intelligence and know-how to oppose an enemy that has just now launched a Sputnik into space? Where can we look today, in 1957, to guarantee that we don't wake up one morning and find that all our street signs are printed in Mongolian? There's only one place to look. Look to the skies. For there in the skies, Americans will meet aliens, different in appearance from us, but similar in their desire for freedom from oppression. There will, of course, be some bad aliens. Some of them may even be mutants. They will have bombs more powerful than our A-bomb. But if we put our hope into research and development and our faith into a strong offensive...
There's nothing up there.
I don't see anything either.
How ridiculous.
What's he talking about?
That guy's a dumb asteroid.
Yeah, he's nuts.
Yeah.